we would celebrate your excellence as a great volleyball player. Sorry, I had to read that again because it shocked me that Wamoyo could play volleyball. How you would make us, your younger siblings, toe the line. How no one could ever touch your domas because you love them so, so much. And I can attest that whenever Wamoyo went to Gishagi, should come with a lot of domas, which are my mom's favorite. Still learning how to love them. Lucy, you have gone too soon. It comforts me to know that there are others out there thinking of and mourning for the great sister you are. Rest in peace, dear sister, till we meet again.
Thank you very much, Kameri, and for all of you who have stood to speak here this afternoon, we really appreciate your tributes, your thoughts that you have shared with us. I will be inviting the media team shortly to share with us a tribute in terms of images and photographs that shows moments of Moyo's life. It is very hard, really, to capture the life of anyone in a matter of minutes. But if Wamoyo was here today, she would say, these were the moments of my life. And so, media team, please cue us in. I know the reel is a bit long. When I stand up, we'll just have to stop there, given time where we are. But please go ahead.
If I had only known the last time would be the last time, I would have put off all the things I had to do. I would have stayed a little longer, held on a little tighter. Now what I'd give for one more day with you. There's a wound here in my heart where something's missing, and they tell me that it's gonna heal with time. But I know you're in a place where all your wounds have been erased, and knowing yours are healed is healing mine. The only scars in heaven, it won't be long to me. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now. I know the road you walked was anything but easy. You picked up your share of scars along the way. Oh, but now you're standing in the sun. You fought your fight and your race is run. The pain is all a million miles away. The only scars in heaven, it won't belong to me. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, scars in heaven, yeah, are on the hands that hold you now. Not a day goes by that I don't see you. You live on in all the better parts of me. Until I'm standing with you in the sun, I'll fight this fight and this race I'll run. Until I finally see what you can see. Oh, the only scars in heaven, they won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, and even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven? That hold you now.
Thank you. As we will soon receive the last tribute, I would like to invite Damaris, please, on behalf of the women of the church. Or are you doing a song? Please come quickly. Or they'll do it later? They'll do it later. Okay, I hear you'll do it later. And so we'll then move to the last tribute. For those of you who have followed Wamoyo's life, it's really been an amazing journey from very humble beginnings to finding her space, finding her place, and if I may add, finding rest. Moyo found rest in one heart, Eddie's heart. Not every relationship brings rest, but this one certainly did. And their relationship was something many of us would admire. So the last tribute is from her dear husband, Eddie Kitonga Omuse. Eddie.
The year was 2013 when we first met. On that day, I was with my friends and you came and joined our table. We all had a great time. I recall when nighttime arrived, you told me that you were feeling cold. Since you did not have a jacket, neither did I have one, I removed my shirt, which I had on, and offered it to you. Interestingly enough, you sweetly declined as you were concerned I would freeze, given that I was only wearing a vest underneath. I immediately knew you were a special lady, and I told you that you would one day be my wife, to which you laughed and told me that I was a clown. As fate would have it, 3 years later, we got engaged and got married on 24th November 2017. Our marriage has been blissful. In fact, we were to celebrate our 6th year wedding anniversary this month, November. You have been my rock, always giving me hope and comfort whenever I'm down, and telling me whatever challenges I go through, that they are only for a season, as things would work out well. You have constantly shown great love to our son Jaden and our daughter Kelani and myself. You always lit up any room with your presence and put a smile on everyone's face, including those who are meeting you for the first time. You have always had a big heart for giving. Even when you didn't have much, you ensured that the little you had, you shared with anyone in need. You have been a great role model to our children and I, and have always taught our son Jaden great values to which he has always adhered to. I still do not believe you are no more, and living life without you by my side is the greatest challenge I have faced my entire life. Your sudden departure has left a huge hole in my heart. I do not know how and if it will ever get filled. As you always told me, everything happens for a reason. I believe you are enjoying yourself in heaven, entertaining all the angels with your humor. We dearly miss you, and I will continue fulfilling your legacy here on earth until the day my time is up and I can join you. Our son Jaden is yet to comprehend what has happened. However, every day he says a prayer in which he asks God to take care of you. We shall always cherish the great memories that we have had together as a family. I send lots of love to you from Jaden, Kelani, and myself. Rest well and in peace, my beloved wife and mother to our children, Jaden and Kelani. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Pastor, sincerely on behalf of the collective family, thank you so much for indulging us and allowing us to exhale. I'd like to hand over to Elder Joanne to pick up from here. Thank you.
Thank you, Peter, for taking us through that session. We truly want to thank God. It's time for presentations, and we have two, one from the Manuera family, and then the other one from the members of PCA Church, or the members of this church, the men and the ladies. Let's have the Manuera family first.
Elder Damaris, Elder Damaris, just come. Joe, just hold on. Joe, just hold on. Elder Damaris, I want you to say something before we speak, we sing, because you are part of us. Just something brief.
Bwana asifiwe. My heart is heavy. But we are told to give thanks to God in all circumstances, and that's what I'm doing. As part of the Manuera family, my request to Edward is that our desire is that you may desire to live in the house of the Lord, meditating upon his word all the days of your life. Amen.
Thank you. Let us have the members of the church, wherever you are, we come and present our song. Yes. Members of the church.
With heavenly comfort, Lord, whatever I do, wherever I be, still 'tis God's hand that leadeth me. He leadeth me. Sometimes where he has power.
Thank you. As we prepare to hear the word of God, I would request that we all stand. We all stand and sing. Sorry, but at least you have stretched. Let's have our seats. We hear the word of God, and then we shall do the song as we prepare ourselves. Let me have Jane Ngaki to read the word of God from 1 Peter, chapter 1, verse 3 to 7. Good afternoon. Our reading today comes from the book of 1 Peter, chapter 1, 3 to 7. And it says, "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade. This inheritance is kept in heaven for you, who through faith are shielded by God's power until the coming of the salvation that is ready to be revealed in the last time. In all this, you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while you may have had to suffer grief in all kinds of trials. These have come so that the proven genuineness of your faith, of greater worth than gold, which perishes even though refined by fire, may result in praise, glory, and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Now we can actually stand. Let us stand and sing the hymn. It's what a fellowship. Okay, thank you.
What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, being on the everlasting love.
Indeed, Lord, our joy, our strength is only found in leaning on your everlasting arm. Our joy, our consolation, our hope is found on you, Lord. On our own, we have no strength to give tributes, to share, to even expound on your word this afternoon. But by your strength, O Lord, it is possible. Minister to us by your word. Through me, in Jesus' name we pray. We may have our seats. Good afternoon, everyone. Praise the Lord. This is not one of the easiest services for anyone to be in. And these are the moments, as a minister, I wish I am not the one preaching. Because it isn't an easy moment for any of us that have known Wamuyu, have walked this journey with Wamuyu. It isn't an easy journey for any of us. When Wamuyu passed on and I went home that day and I was with Eddie and he was sharing the story and encouraging him to repeat the story over and over, I even did not know what to tell him at that moment. In those moments you are like, you won't tell them it's the will of God? No. Do you want to say God has given, the Lord has taken away? Then the question is, why take away at this hour? Someone was not sick, someone was very young. When I was called, because the first news came from Shifra Geshaga and she called me, we actually couldn't be able to finish the conversation on the phone. I had to disconnect the phone. Didn't even have the strength to go through the phone. Because it was within a very short span after we had buried the mother. And I had ministered in the mother's funeral in Ishamara, in Nyeri. And in that funeral, one of the things I was saying is that the mother died too young, at 56. And that was my lament, that the mother has died too young at only 56. And I remember that in the funeral. Now, if the mother was young, what of the daughter? That is even more painful. And when the mother passed on, and again we went to the home, and I went to pray with the family, kept on encouraging Wamuyu on her pregnancy. And we prayed that God will help her to carry through the pregnancy because she was due.
and prayed that God will help her to deliver the baby after the mother's funeral so that there's no complications before. And God answered the prayer. And she was able to deliver a healthy baby girl. And she texted and called me on the 21st of October. I was actually going through that text now. And excited about baby Kellan. And, you know, signed off Wamuyo and Getonga in that text. So now even I was asking myself, God, did we pray for the baby's delivery and forgot to pray for the mother? Did we pray for the pregnancy and forgot to pray for the mother? So, God, what do we do in such like a case? I was telling Elder Joanne, all what we've done is what we needed to have come and do. Sit around, remember Amoyo, mourn her with the family, and then say, there is hope in God. Hallelujah. Amen. That God who gave us Amoyo, it is God who has taken away, as painful as it is. When I lost my grandmother and she was 96, the last thing I wanted to hear is anyone telling me it is the will of God for her to die. And it was 96, and it was extremely painful. So now how do I stand here and tell Eddie and tell the Omuses and the Geshagas and the Manueras that it is God's will she should rest? But in fact, imagine, family, that's what I was to tell you. Praise be to God, that it is the will of God. For those of you that are visiting here for the first time, this is PC Loresho Community Church, where you are welcome, wanted, and loved, and we welcome you. Anytime you're in Nairobi and you want to worship somewhere, come. And if you want to make it your church, we love people. And we are not saying it for the sake of saying it. When you say you're welcome, wanted, and loved, we mean it. And you're welcome here. Beloved in the Lord, in the next very few minutes, and what I say today, don't judge me from this. Hallelujah. This is one of the hardest sermons I even had to prepare. Because this really has touched me. Because, like, again, I say, I'm not saying that I love burying, but when you're doing the funeral of a 90-year-old, 95, 100, you truly can be able to say, you have lived your life. You have fought the good fight. You have completed the race. Now, how do I tell you that Wamuyo has completed the race when I don't know what to tell Jaden as he grows up? When we visited the home and I looked at Jaden still walking around and sitting on the table seeking attention, all of us sitting around, I'm like, I looked at that boy and I was like, how will the father explain to this boy what happened to the mother? All will be left is the images of the mother, not to mention baby Kellan. Beloved in the Lord, I will tell you today there is hope in God. And that's all I want to tell you. If you forget everything else I say, I will tell you there is hope in God. And that is what I am here to tell you today. There's no hope in any other person. No hope in a human being. No hope in a physician. I was preaching that on Sunday. There's no even hope in a physician. Where a lady in Mark chapter 5 verses 25 to 34 had spent all her resources with a physician, that's what the Bible says, and finally she ended up with nothing. I'm here to say, there is only hope in God. For Amoyo, even the husband could not be able to bring her back to life. He tried his level best. He shared the story. Even called the brother who is a medical doctor. Called the ambulance was on the way coming. As he went outside to open for the ambulance to come in, goes back and the brother comes out telling him, sorry. And he's like, sorry for what? Your wife is no more. So the only hope we have, church, the only hope we have, Christians, is in God. And that's what James Dobson says, holding on to your faith, even when that faith does not seem to make sense. Because like now, it may be like, how do I hold on to that faith? How will you face tomorrow? How the day after, how will the day after be? Hold on to your faith. Have your hope in God. Biblical hope is a confident expectation of what God has promised, and its strength is in his faithfulness. That God is faithful. Even when all of us fail, none of us is able to do it. The brother, the sister, the family, as we look around, the parents, because the desire of every parent is that our children will lay us to rest. That's the desire of a parent. My desire is that God will keep me around here. I'm old enough that my children will bury me, not me burying my children. So the Omuses, Manuelas, all we can tell you, God is still faithful even now. We do not know why he has taken Wamoyo. I'm not here to tell you that I have an answer. I don't have an answer. And I'm not asking for one. He knows he's better. Someone told me one time when I lost my grandma, and I asked so many questions. And someone told me, leave the answers to God. Don't ask him questions. He might call you home so that he gives you the answers. And I was like, seriously, I don't want to go home to give you given the answers. Eh? Let me stay without the answers. So family, don't ask so many questions so that God does not tell you, please, since you have so many questions, come, I tell you. You do not want to go to be given the answers over there. Please stay here. You don't know why. Just know God had a reason. That reason we don't know. Praise be to God. Why leave those young kids around there? Why? We do not know. All with the our hope is knowing that God is still faithful, even in that situation we are in. Hope is a necessity and not a luxury. We cannot be able to live and do without hope. Hope is a necessity and not a luxury. Our hope is in God's love, that he still loves us. And that's why he will tell us even that Romans 8, 28 to 30, nothing can separate us from that love. Not even the death of our loved Wamoyo. No, that still cannot be able to separate us from the love of God. You know, many times even in philosophy, we'll try to find reason and we'll not be able to. Study philosophy, science, try to understand about hope and what can give us hope. We don't. But the beauty of the Christian faith is that it begins with God. Praise be to God. And that brings sense to the rest of the creation and the rest of life. So if you tried science, medicine, and you tried that, Eddie, called medics around, called an ambulance, still cannot be able to give us an answer. What gives us an answer about God's love is when we begin with God and then works down to man. That there is hope in God and it's a necessity, and we hold his love. Wamoyo is gone. Her love for you, you'll not experience it as used to. But God still loves you. Praise be to God. He still does. Our hope is also in the resurrection. Because the Bible says, and we have a reason to believe in the Bible, that Christ resurrected. And this is not a fanciful fiction we are talking about. When you talk about Christ resurrecting, it's not a fiction. It is a reality. Why? Because the Bible says so. And we have a reason to believe in the Bible. Those people that have lived in history and denied the Bible has outlived them. And I love sharing this story. The Roman Empire was the greatest empire that ever lived. They even tried to annihilate all the Christians. The Roman Empire died. The Bible and Christianity is still here. Praise be to God. Remember even the great USSR. The great USSR, those who went to school those days, United Socialist Soviets of Russia. You know, there were two some SS following one another. Eh? I know the first one was United, the other one, the last one was Russia. But there were two SS in between. You know, and it was such a big thing. Then, and they even declared the Bible a dangerous good. You could not even carry the Bible around. They would arrest you. That big, whatever, a socialist Soviet, it died. Kina Bosnia, kina Herzegovina, kina Chechnya, ika katika katika yote ikaisha. The Bible they declared a dangerous good is still here with us. So if you have no reason to believe the Bible, believe in your history. Hallelujah. The history is here with us. Believe in the history. And it is the Bible that tells us Christ resurrected and he went to prepare for us a place in heaven where he is, we will also be there. Hallelujah. So please, Eddie, and your boy and girl, tell them even as they grow up, you know what? The Bible says that Mamu will resurrect. And if we believe in God, where Mommy is, we will be with her someday. So all we need to do is believe in the Bible and believe that indeed where she is, we are also going to be there. Beloved in the Lord, build. Hope is built on the past. What God has done, like I'm saying, in history, what God has done in the past, influences the present and looks to the future. That's what hope does to each one of us. Already you look into what God has done in the past. Just look at some pictures to look a cake around there. So you look into what God has done in the days that have passed. Then that past influences our present. That's why confidently I can preach about Christ as if I was there when he walked around the earth. Hallelujah. Because of the past and what history has told me and our faith. And then it inspires the future. Look to the future. So don't just look into the pain and the death of our loved Wamoyo. Look into Christ of what has happened in the past. Trust him for what he will do. And hope looks into something to do, which is to worship God. Bury yourself in the love of God. And then love God. Something to love. And then something to look forward to. The resurrection to meet with our beloved one. Praise be to God. Because if you love God, God will always provide a solution for today, tomorrow, and days to come. I'll tell you, the family of Manueras and Geshagas, and all of us, even Omuses, hope is embracing newness in life. Something new in life. Look at something new in life. There's something new God is doing. There's something new God is doing. Look into the shoot. I remember one time, I was talking about this somewhere. That Kashoot in the desert looks like in a hopeless situation in a desert. That Kashoot will show like in that hopeless situation in a desert, somewhere, God can cause something green. How he'll cause something, a shoot to come up in your dryness of life, in the pain you are going through, God knows how he'll do that. Trust God for some newness in life. A shoot coming up in your life. God will do something new in this family. Pain does not last forever. Pain will be there today. Pain will not be there tomorrow. God will make something new. How he'll do that newness in your life, he is the one who knows how we'll make the newness in life. With hope, struggles only make us stronger. It's like God holding your hand. We all go through struggles in life. Right now we are struggling and we're in pain. I would pray that in your struggle, in your pain, God will make you stronger. Where you could look back and say, I never lost hope when Wamoyo died. Even now I not lose hope. You know, hope makes us stronger even with the new tomorrow. Don't lose your hope. Don't let fear overtake your hope. Remember who you are. You are a child of God. And the same God who has brought you this far, God will not discard you. Remember, you are a conqueror. You have conquered many. I've listened to your story. Meeting a girl for the first time and telling her you're going to be my wife. Even for me, born again, spirit filled, and I had fasted. When I met my wife for the first time, I even was not able to tell her I love you. I remember even my first date. And it's very interesting because I took my wife for the first date. We went to the resurrection garden. So we went the way of the cross. You know the way of the cross? We went to the way of the cross. So how do you go the way of the cross up to the resurrection? Then you tell somebody you want to, you love them, eh? And you know you have gone through the sorrowful, the journey of Christ until finally that, eh? So all you could do is quote every Bible verse and then escort her home. And then when I went to it, was, you know, saying, I should have told her my intention, eh? So, Eddie, even the first day you had the confidence to tell a girl, you will be my wife. Not even I love you. I didn't hear even you saying, I love you. I heard you telling her that I heard you telling her you'll be my wife, even willing to take off your shirt and remain without anything, eh? And cover her with your shirt. You are a conqueror. You have made it in the past, and even now you'll make it. You will make it. Your boy and your son and your girl will make it. Don the armor of God every day in your life. The armor that you may will be able to help you to go on with life is the armor of hope, and which is the armor of God, as indicated in the book of Ephesians. Put on the full armor of God. The moment you try to find solace, and I remember mentioning this on Sunday, you try to find solace on other things, that solace will be short-lived. If you try to find it in friends, they'll be here tomorrow, they'll not be there. We are about to do benediction, and we'll go our different ways, but God is the only one who will not leave you. The rest of us will. Please adorn the armor of God, which is what you need. Do not waste your time on trivial matters, on advices that will not help you. Please plug yourself in the love of God and hope in God. Learn from every challenge you face now and in the days to come. And you are loved. Remember, you are loved by the Most High God more than anything else. Finally, go with God. The rest of us will go our different ways. Even after Saturday and traveling, all of us, and some of us traveling to Busia and later, go with God. There is hope in Him and the entire family. He is your Father. Don't lose your hope in Him. He'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. And that's, go read that first Peter again on your own. You can read the story of Peter and what he went through and never gave up. He had hope in God. And in our call to worship today, in Psalms 42 and verses 5. Why am I struggling? I will hope in God. The entire family, may you put your life in the life of God, and He will never leave you or forsake you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We'll request us to be upstanding, even as I invite Reverend Lorraine to come over. We want to say a prayer for the family. I'm inviting Reverend Lorraine to come and commit the family to God in prayer. When we asked the Laurentia people to sing, she didn't come up, and she's a part of this congregation. And I request the family to come over here. Be upstanding here. And then I'll ask the elders in the house. And thank you, Elder Jane and Elder Kariuki, all the way from Nyeri, coming over to be with us. I'll ask the family to stand over here so that the elders can stand before you, so that we commit you to God in prayer. Probably ask a few other elders to go on that desk. Thank you. There are elders there. Kingori is not, Oidaka is alone here. So Kingori, you can join him on this other side so that we have enough people surrounding the elders. Elders surrounding the family. Symbolically, why do we do this? We surround you as a sign that God will surround you. The angels will encamp around you. That's why I'm asking the elders to go around you, as a sign that the angels will encamp you and they will go together with you. Yes, Jaden, it's going to be well. Thank you.
Let us pray. Gracious and holy God, in the beginning of all things, Lord, you looked around and you brought forth life. And so you, God, we know that you are the creator of life. So you are the one who has given us Suamoyo. Lord, and it is into your gracious hands that she was welcomed. That she she was welcomed home into eternal rest and into eternal delight. Today, when you welcome your children home, often they leave a void here in this world, in the hearts and the lives of those who have loved them, those who have walked with them, those who today, God, are saying, that really wasn't enough time. And God, we love you and we trust you, and it still wasn't enough time for her children, for Eddie, for all of her family members and her friends, and even this church, which has watched her grow and become the woman that she was. And so, God, today we pray that you will surround each and every member of her family with your love and with your comfort and with your peace. God, when you walked on this earth as Jesus Christ, Lazarus died, God, and Jesus wept with his family because he felt the pain of loss. God, and when Jesus was on the cross, we know that you felt that pain as well. And so, God, you do not forsake us, but indeed you weep with us when our hearts are broken. You join us in the depths of our pain so that you can bring forth new life, as Reverend Karanja reminded us, that in the midst of despair, God, there is hope because we have hope in Jesus Christ. We have hope in his resurrection. We have hope that you join us in our suffering so that we might join you in glory. So God, again, we pray for Eddie and Jaden and Kilani. We pray for the Gashaga family, for the Amuse family, for everyone who loved Wamuyu. God, that their hope might be in you, that each and every day they will walk with Jesus Christ so that they might join their beloved again in glory. It's in the name of your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ, that we live and that we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Lorraine. We can have our seats. We're going to give an offering. And the offering that we give is good to be clear. That offering we give is not for PCL Oratio Community Church. That offering we are giving is to the family of the Omuses so that it can help them. Yes, yes, praise worship team, you can help us, lead us in the worship. So the offering we are giving is for the family. So yes, thank you. You can come stand here probably. Can I assure you the ushers, Jenny Msimame Hapa, so then the people can come. You can have one person standing over there, over here, there. Thank you. Thank you, Nick. Jenny. We can all be upstanding here. The offering we are giving goes to the family. It is for the family, to help them in the preparations and everything else that we have. We have enough. Ash, or some of you want to stand at the back. Yes. Jennifer and Shiro, you can. Although tunapenda kule kuja, tulete mbele. It's okay here. Tunatosha Njeri, you can songa here. Thank you, Naomi. Thank you. We can worship as we bring forth our offering to support the family, please. This goes to the family. Karibuni. Thank you.
God. We need you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for enabling us to support, to be a shoulder to lean on for this family, Lord. Thank you, God, for this offering. As they go and use them, Lord, we present it unto you, Jehovah, so that they can use it for the glory and honor of your name. If a giver, Lord, bless his or her territory and bless the work of our heart in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the church say,
Thank you very much. We are almost coming to the end of the service. And before we do the vote of thanks, we want to recognize CWA St. Paul's, or where the Omuses family worship. And before we do the vote of thanks, I would like to call them up here. They had a presentation. We were told a bit, but they can come to present. Please see W.A. St. Paul. Thank you.
Nimevipiga vita, nimevipiga vita, vilivyo vizuri. Nimevipiga vita, nimevipiga vita, vilivyo vizuri. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Baada ya hayo, nimewekewa taji. Nimewekewa taji, taji ya ahadi. Nimevipiga vita, nimevipiga vita, vilivyo vizuri. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Sasa namiminwa, nao wakati wangu wakufariki kwangu nao umefika. Nimevipiga vita, nimevipiga vita, vilivyo vizuri. Nimevipiga vita, nimevipiga vita, vilivyo vizuri. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda. Mwendo nimeumaliza, imani nimeilinda.
Thank you, St. Paul's. May God bless you for reminding us that we continue holding on to our faith. I want to call upon Dr. Jeffrey Omose for vote of thanks and announcements.
Sorry, my name is Karaoke. Once again, I shall be sharing that responsibility with Jeff. Mine is to sincerely thank you all, first and foremost, for being here this afternoon. I know it's a work day, and on behalf of the Omuse and the Gishaga family, we do sincerely appreciate your being here with us, standing with these dear families at this time, and we would say thank you very, very much. We would like to thank PCL Racial Community Church. Thank you, Pastor, the leadership of the church. We thank you for opening this sanctuary for these two dear families and for being able to be here with us even during the week. We thank you for the services that you have led at home, and we do appreciate and feel your love. We also want to acknowledge St. Paul's Catholic Church. We also acknowledge the way you've stood with the two families at home and also here, and please do pass our love and greetings to your parish minister and say that we do appreciate them as a family. We'd like to thank other friends and colleagues who have been with us since Wamoyo rested. I've been coming home. Thank you for the dear messages that you've been sending, even for other kinds of support that we have received during the week. We do thank you so, so much for strengthening Eddie and his two dear children and the family at this difficult time. There's some special partners who have given flowers today. We want to thank Adonai Partners for your gracious donation of flowers. We do acknowledge you, and we say thank you so much. Emmanuel Jumbo, I know you're somewhere. Thank you so much for donating your time and to do photography this afternoon. We thank you. Once again, God bless you. And as you've refreshed this family, may the good Lord refresh you too. God bless you.
God is good and all the time. So I'd really like to again join Peter in really thanking all of you for joining us in this memorial service. Thank you very much, Reverend Dr. Karanja. Thank you, Elder Johan, and your team. Now, I love church. I'm a Catholic. And one thing that we always love about church is the order. But I would like to request Father to allow me to create a little bit of disorder just for 1 minute. There's a group of people who are mourning just as we are, who have been working with our beloved sister, and those are the people from Adonai, her colleagues, who have been working with her every day. We actually miss them when we're doing the tributes, and they've supported us in a very big way. They've come with so many flowers, you know, the beautiful flowers. Wamuyu's favorite color was fuchsia. I know the men have no idea what fuchsia is. Yeah, so if they deny the colleagues of Lucy Wamuyu, if you're here, you can stand up. Whatever you want, wave. Thank you very much. Thank you for all your support. We will provide a slot for you to give a tribute when we have the service back home. Maybe just to briefly explain one thing. I think I would say you are her colleagues, and I am sure you are great colleagues. And why do I say that? When the committee of experts was writing the eulogy, and it came to writing the bit about employment, we actually relied on the CV. And it's very obvious that Wamuyu never planned to leave you, because she was yet to update that she was currently working at Adonai. Oftentimes we update our CVs when we're looking for another job. So thank you for all the support that you've offered, and we'll offer you a slot to give a tribute back home. So I actually stand, and I'm speaking on behalf of, as I call them, a committee of experts. when the tragedy happened, I can tell you, we really didn't know where to start. I personally didn't know where to start. And I keep on telling people that it took me a while to realize that there were no Wazes to start organizing Wamuyu's farewell, and that I was part of the group called Wazes, and that we had to take leadership and actually move forward. So I actually stand here because there are many people who have actually held our hand. All of you have done that, and you've done that very ably, and we really appreciate, and we shall be eternally grateful for all your support. Keep praying for us. We've been meeting. They are truly a committee of experts. I learned, and someone told me at the very beginning, you're not the first person to go through this. And indeed, we have learned, and we have worked together, and we believe that on Saturday, we will lay our beloved sister to rest. And please keep on praying for the family, the children who've been left behind, and all of us. I think we all need strength at this trying time. So what are the plans from today until we lay our beloved sister to rest? Today's Wednesday. We planned the memorial service, and this has gone excellent. Tomorrow, we are planning to have a viewing at Montezuma Funeral Home, which is off Mbagathi Way, between 1 and 1:30 p.m. We do recognize that there are many of you who would love to travel with us back home, and you won't be able to do so. So if you're available and you'd like to view and say prayers, we'll be meeting at Montezuma at sharp 1 p.m., and we'll be done by 1:30 p.m. So you'll find us there, and we'll be able to organize for the same. On Friday, we depart for home. Home is in Busia County, Teson North Sub-County. Google Maps, if you want to Google Moding Secondary School. It might indicate that it is somewhere in Uganda. It is not. It's just because we're very close to the border. But Moding Secondary School will bring you to the secondary school, which is just a few meters from home. We depart on Sunday at 6:30 a.m. We intend to have prayers between 6:15 and 6:30 a.m. at the Montezuma Funeral Home. They have a chapel, and hopefully depart on time at 6:30 because it is really a long journey, 8 to 9 hours to home. We will lay Wamui to rest on Saturday and travel back on Sunday. So we do hope to see you there. If you don't make it, please pray with us. We pray for journey masses, and we are hopeful that at the end of the day, all will be well. So thank you very much, and I think I hand it over back to Peter. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much for those announcements. Now I'll call upon Damaris Waigancho to pray for a cup of tea, and then we'll get benediction. And also to let you know that the family invites all the congregants to pick a rose on their way out as a sample of the legacy of a fragrance of a life well lived. Thank you.
Thank you, Elder John. Let us pray for a cup of tea. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for a beautiful memorial service that we've had this afternoon. Thank you for reminding us that you are our hope. Lord, you are constant in all areas of our lives. And even in this time, oh God, when things are so difficult, you are constant and you never change. May you continue being a comforter to the Omuses and to the Gishaga. Lord, we thank you for the tea and the snacks that have been prepared for us. We ask that you may bless it, O God. We know there are people who do not have anything to eat, Lord. We pray that you may help them to get somebody to give them something to eat. And if it is us, Lord, you will use to touch those people who have nothing to eat. May you, Lord, be used of you. Thank you for the rains that you continue giving us. We pray that, Lord, there are enough rains so that the crops in the field may grow and our rivers may fill up, O God. Thank you for everything good that comes from you. We remember those who have prepared the cup of tea and the snacks. We ask that you may bless them. Sanctify everything that we'll take this afternoon, for we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Brother Joan tells me his benediction, then him. So we may be upstanding. And then after that, the worship team will lead us with, "Guide me, O thy great Jehovah." Then as we pray that the Lord will continue guiding you, all the Moses and Nyueran Geshavas. And when you go back to St. Paul, the Catholic Women Association pass our regards to your parish priest, Father Kaigua. And you personally pass my greetings, a personal friend. And thank you very much for being here. The Lord be with you. And for any of you that does not have a church where you worship, you're welcome here. Any of you looking forward to changing churches, you're welcome here. Because you're welcome, wanted, and loved. That's who we are. So you're welcome to join us here and be glad. And we welcome you with both our hands. The Lord bless you, keep you this day and always. Let us pray. And now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling, be glory, honor, and majesty. May the mighty loving God lift up his countenance upon you and be gracious to you. May the mighty loving God watch over your going out and your coming in this afternoon and all the days of your life. May the mighty and loving God speak comfort and life to each one of you this day and always. May the mighty and loving God give you peace that surpasses human understanding. And may that peace that passes human understanding keep your heart and your minds in the love of God, the Son, Jesus Christ. And may the blessings of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with all of you now and forevermore. Amen.
We may leave now and have a cup of tea together. Thank you.